South Florida's own stage, beer popping on B. Miami stand up, I got special guests in the building. I got Rico Love, I got Young Chris in the building. Yeah. Rico Love, what's the name of the label?
Division 1.
So Division 1 is in the building.
Yes. Turn the lights on.
Young Chris, congratulations.
Thank you, brother. I appreciate it.
Rico Love, congratulations.
Thank
and the reason why I'm congratulating these two brothers, Rico Love has got a big label deal at Universal Records. Division 1, a big power move. And if you don't know Rico Love is behind a lot of hit records that play on the radio. Rico Love, just tell them a few of them. It's a few of them.
We got Hello, Good Morning.
Okay.
Daddy's Home, Usher.
Okay.
We got There Goes My Baby, Usher. Sweet Dreams, Beyonce. We got Living Better Now, Jamie Foxx blowing up right now. Crazy.
I love that record.
Featuring Rosé. Yeah. Shout out to Rosé. We got Just a Dream, Nelly.
Safe to say, them royalty checks and them up checks is always on time.
God is good, man. Yo, this is Rico Love, Mr. Turn the Lights On. I want to introduce the Street Banger, the first single off the reintroduction. Pre-album, this is Break 'Em Down, Young Chris featuring yours truly, Rico Love. Turn the lights on.
Let's get it poppin', it's 99 Champs, Young Chris, Rico Love.
Right now.
Here's another Street Banger on South Florida's only station for hip-hop and R&B.
Turn the lights on. Break up, bitch down. Break up, bitch down.
What up? It's Rico Love, TTLO, Blow Up Party Edition. I want to talk about winners. You know, I always talk about surviving and striving and living and fighting, but I just want to talk about winners. You know what winners do? They celebrate. And what you got to do sometimes in life, you got to take time out to celebrate, to appreciate everything that brought you to where you are. You know what I'm saying? And I'm so blessed today. I'm here at in Miami for the Division 1 launch party, getting ready to go out and do my thing, getting ready to do MTV with the homie Usher, you know what I mean? Then we're gonna hit Red, then we're gonna hit Mansion and all that. And tomorrow night we get Cameo, whatever. But long story short, I feel like it's healthy for us to celebrate. And I'm so appreciative of all the my peers in the music business who came out to support me, who showed mad love, who continue to show mad love, because that's what I reciprocate to them, you know? So we just gonna have a good time tonight, we're gonna party, you know what I mean? Little story real quick. In 2002, I got the opportunity to meet the homie Usher. I was working with the Corner Boys and sleeping on their couch, trying to make it happen. Couldn't have a pot of piss in. And then he was doing a remix album at the time. He asked him to produce a beat. So I rapped on one of the joints that they did, and he heard it. He invited me to perform at a showcase. After I performed at the showcase, he saw me, he said, "Yo, I like your style, I want to give you a situation." I signed to Us Records as a rap artist, and I was so excited, I was gung-ho about the situation, but then it was like nothing was moving, nothing was happening, so I was tripping out like, whoa, what part of the game is this? Like, I thought I was supposed to get $1 million, I thought it was supposed to be lights, cameras, actors, bitches, you know what I mean? All that crazy stuff, but reality of it was, I hadn't put in that work, I hadn't put in that time. So I went to Usher's office and I'm like, "Yo, what's up, man? I need some money." I told everybody in my family I had a record deal, I'm supposed to be taking care of my whole family. He said, "Listen, I can give you some money or I can give you an opportunity to have a career." He saw something very special in me and he said, "Yo, I'm gonna give you a chance." So he gave me this track that Just Blaze had produced, and he asked me, he said, "Yo, everybody been trying to write to this beat, can nobody write to it? Just write a song to it." He said, "Something about your flow that I can hear melody in. So I think you could be a great songwriter." And the way him and Mark Pitts described it was like, "Yo, you're gonna be the rap R. Kelly." So I was like, "Alright, whatever." I took the beat, and Usher was in Las Vegas for the American Music Awards, I'll never forget. And my manager at the time, Cersei, he said, "Yo, don't rap, write a song, write a real song." So I sat in the car, I had a phone, because I never go around down the road or anything. I had a phone, and I sang Throwback into the phone. And that was the first song I ever wrote. And after that, I went on a tour, Usher and the Truth Tour, coming out every night with him, performing Throwback. And I look back and I say, damn, that guy, that opportunity that I got back in 2002, the one that got me on the Confessions album, the one that made me a part of history, 29 million worldwide. So, and it got me to this point. So, I'm winning. But the game ain't over. We still got a lot more to play. So, this is just the first quarter. We want to be champions. This is one game. It's a lot more games to go to get all the way to that chip. Well, yeah, turn the lights on.
Bitch now. See